Hi everyone, welcome back to the current affairs series of agriculture and rural development. My name is Pooja Rawat and this is our 28th session in the series. So as we all know, NABARD notification is out and there are a lot of changes with respect to eligibility criteria and exam pattern. Now there will be a descriptive type of questions in the phase 2. Alright, so don't get panicked, we'll be coming with the series on descriptive questions for the agriculture and rural development. Alright. So you don't have to worry, just have your focus and just keep studying, all right? So let's start our session. And before we begin, all those people who are here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. You can also join our Telegram group wherein you can post your queries and you'll also be notified with the upcoming videos and the latest examination patterns and the notifications. So let's start our session. This is the first question. Which of the following is correct with respect to livestock census 2019? So in today's session, we'll be discussing about the livestock census, a very important one, right? So in the previous session, we were discussing about the agriculture census. So I was telling you that these censuses are very important and you will get 2-3 questions from these areas. All right. So, सबसे पहले तो livestock क्या होता है? Livestock are the farm animals which are raised either for their products, for example, milk or meat, right? Or for their labor. Okay, so these are the farm animals that are raised for their products or their labor, right? This livestock census has been conducted by Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy, okay. Animal Husbandry and Dairy, alright. So this census is conducted once in 5 years. So remember these points and livestock mein aapke kaun kaun se animal aa jaate hain? Livestock mein you'll have cattle, sheep, goat, pigs, mules, camels, right? Mithun, yak. So all these animals will be a part of your livestock. Okay, so livestock census mein basically jitne bhi aapke domesticated animals hain unko count kiya jata hai. All right. So let us discuss this question. First statement is, the total livestock population in the country has shown an increment of 4.6% over the livestock census 2012. So this statement is correct. The total livestock population has increased by 4.6%. Okay, so the previous session or the census was in 2012. So there was a gap or there was a delay in the livestock census of 2019. You can see that the census basically conducted in 5 years, but in this time there was a delay of 2 years because the government was pushing on the digitalization, right? Aur government chahti thi ki this time the data should be recorded through mobile tablets, computer tablets, right? So earlier kya hota tha, manually jo hai field officers manually data ko feed in karte the, but this time they have recorded these data through mobile tablets. Okay, so this was the reason because a lot of capacity development was involved, right? Training should be given to these field officers and the infrastructure should be given. So that's why there was a delay of 2 years. Okay, the second statement is, the total indigenous cattle population has observed a decline of 6%. This one is also correct. Okay, although the cattle population has increased and but the people are or the farmers are going for the exotic breeds. Okay, so they're moving away from these indigenous cattle because agar inka output dekhi, agar ye milk, for example, milk ki agar hum baat kare to exotic breeds, agar jersey ki baat kare to they it gets a good amount of milk so that these farmers get enough prices or enough amount, good remunerative for their product. All right, so that's why they're going towards adopting these more and more exotic breeds and they're shying away from the indigenous cattle. All right, so both of these statements are correct. Now the next question is, which state has the largest cattle population in India as per the livestock census 2019? The options are Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh. Correct answer is B, that is Uttar Pradesh. So Uttar Pradesh has the largest cattle population in India. But remember one thing, agar 2012 or 2019 ko compare kare, so there was a decline in cattle population in Uttar Pradesh. Alright? Now the third question is, choose the correct sequence of different species with respect to their share in the total livestock population. Inka share batana in the total livestock population as per the 20th livestock census. So this is our 20th census, okay? So 1919 mein first time jo hai livestock census wo conduct kiya gaya tha, and the 2019 census was the 20th such census, alright? The correct sequence here is the cattle, followed by goat, then buffaloes and sheep. So cattle accounts for around 36% of the total livestock population. Alright. This is the graphical representation of the total livestock population and their share of the major species. So cattle accounts for 35.94%, so approximately 36%. Right. Then the buffalo, 20.45%. Then we have sheep, 13.87%. Then the goat, pig and the others. So others mein aapka aa jayega mithun, yak, okay, camels. Ye sare species others mein aa jayenge. So the maximum share is cattle and followed by buffaloes. The next question is, the maximum increase in the livestock population is observed in which state? Okay. So Uttar Pradesh has the maximum population or the largest livestock population, but there was a decline in 2019. Now you have to identify which of the states have shown a maximum increase in the livestock population, right? So the correct answer here is the West Bengal followed by Telangana. Okay, the West Bengal has shown the maximum increase. So this is the table of the livestock population and you can see the percentage change. So West Bengal has the maximum increment of 23.3%, followed by Telangana, okay, and then the third number pe aapka aayega Andhra Pradesh, okay, and you can also observe that Uttar Pradesh has shown a decline of 1.35%, although it still has the largest livestock population. Then the Rajasthan also shown a decrement of 1.66%, and then Gujarat, right? Gujarat also shown the decline of 0.95%. So remember this table. And the last question of today's series is, consider the following statement today's session, sorry. Consider the following statement with respect to poultry population. Okay, ab poultry mein kya hota hai? Poultry mein aapka sara domestic fowls aa jayenge, your chickens, ducks, geese, turkeys. Alright, so all these would be considered under your poultry. The first statement is, the total poultry has increased by 16.81%, reaching 851.81 million during 2019. Absolutely correct. There was an increment of 16.8% in the total poultry population, alright? The second statement is, the backyard poultry has increased by around 46%. This one is also correct. So, backyard poultry, which is basically the practicing of poultry at your farm by these farmers in, right? The farmers will be practicing these poultry at their backyards or in their farms, right? So this has also shown an increment of 46%. And this has a significance. Basically, rural empowerment ho raha isse, kya ho raha hai? Because poultry is providing an additional income to these farmers, right? These small and marginal farmers are practicing these poultry in their farms and thereby getting more income or the additional income for themselves, alright? Last statement is, Tamil Nadu has the maximum share in the India's total poultry population. So this one is also correct, so Tamil Nadu has the maximum share. So all of these statements are correct and the correct option would be D. So this is the table of the total poultry population and you can see that Tamil Nadu has the maximum one, contributing of around 120.8 million poultry, right? This one followed by Andhra Pradesh and then Telangana, right? So maximum increment agar hum yaha dekhe to wo hume dekhne ko milta hai Assam mein, theek hai? Agar question is tarike se frame kiya jaye ki which state has shown the maximum increment in the poultry population, So that would be your Assam, followed by West Bengal and Maharashtra, and then Odisha. Okay, or decline agar hum dekhe to Telangana mein, right? Telangana mein aapko decline dekhne ko mila. Although it stands at the third position, it ranks third in the total poultry population, but it has shown a decrement of 0.93%. Now let us just discuss this in a bit of detail. So the livestock census has been conducted in the country every 5 years since 1920. The first census was conducted in 1919. Now it covers all the domesticated animals and their head counts. ठीक है तो जितने भी domesticated animals हैं उन सभी का हेड काउंट किया जाता है, रिकॉर्ड नंबर रिकॉर्ड किया जाता है बेसिकली. सो फॉर 19 सच सेंसस हैव बीन कंडक्टेड. सो दिस वाज द 20th सेशन एंड दिस बीन कंडक्टेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फिशरीज एनिमल हस्बेंड्री एंड डेयरी इन पार्टिसिपेशन विद ऑल द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स एंड द यूटीज. सो ऑल द स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज आर कवर्ड अंडर दिस सेंसस. ऑलराइट, द हाउसहोल्ड लेवल डेटा थ्रू ऑनलाइन ट्रांसमिशन फ्रॉम द फील्ड हैज बीन यूज्ड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम. सो दिस वाज अ यूनिक फीचर of the 20th livestock census, that the data was not recorded manually, but it has been entered through the computer tablets. All right, so there was an online transmission of the data. Now, the another important feature in this year was that the data has been recorded on based on the breed wise. Okay, so breed wise data was recorded for the animals and the poultry birds. All right. Now the major highlights were total livestock population stands at first 535.78 million, which shows an increment of 4.6% as compared to 2012 census. West Bengal has shown the highest increase, followed by Telangana. We have discussed this. Now the total number of cattle in the country has shown an increment of 0.8%. Okay, cattle population 0.8% se increment hua. The cattle mein aapka basically cow and oxes aata hai. So Uttar Pradesh has the largest cattle population. Yes, we know that. Now the population of the total exotic and the crossbred cattle has increased by 27%. The exotic cattle, agar dekhe, crossbred cattle dekhe, so this has shown an increment of 27%, right? Because of their good yield, since they give a good yield, right? So that's why there was an increment in the adoption of these cattle. Okay. Now the population of indigenous cattle has shown a decline of 6%. So this has been declined by 6% indigenous cattle because of their poor yield. Okay. The next point is buffalo population increased by 1%. All right. Sheep population has also recorded an increment of 14.1%, and the goat population has been increased by 10%. Now the pig population has been declined by 12%. So you remember, याद रखिए कि in case अगर आपको ये figure नहीं भी याद होती है, तो आप livestock तो याद ही रखिएगा कि total livestock population कितना है and कितने percentage से increment हुआ है, right? Otherwise आप इतना जरूर याद रखिएगा कि almost सारी species हम जो भी देख रहे हैं, उसमें आपको as compared to 2012 there has been an increment of something figure, right? ठीक है, 1%, 2%, 10% जो है कोई ना कोई इंक्रीमेंट आपको देखने को मिला है. बट कुछ एक स्पीशीज हैं, फॉर एग्जांपल इंडिजीनियस कैटल की हमने बात करी है ना, इंडिजीनियस कैटल, तो इसमें क्या हुआ, डिक्लाइन देखने को मिला है. नेक्स्ट हमें कहाँ देखने को मिल रहा है, पिग पॉपुलेशन में डिक्लाइन देखने को मिल रहा है. तो एक ओवरव्यू आप बना के रख लीजिए कि इंडिजीनियस कैटल में देर वॉज अ डिक्लाइन एंड देन द पिग्स पॉपुलेशन वॉज डिक्लाइन. सो दीज आर द यूनिक फीचर्स है ना, कुछ जो अलग दिख रहा है आपको. देन 16.8% इंक्रीमेंट वॉज रजिस्टर्ड इन द टोटल पोल्ट्री पॉपुलेशन. बैकयार्ड पोल्ट्री में 46% का राइज हुआ है. टोटल कमर्शियल पोल्ट्री देखें तो इट हैज शोन एन इंक्रीमेंट ऑफ 4.1%. देन द टोटल बोवाइन पॉपुलेशन वॉज increased by 1%. तो बोवाइन में आपके सब क्या जाएंगे, कैटल्स भी आ जाएंगे, बफेलोज, मिथुन एंड यांग, राइट. तो दिस हैज शोन एन इंक्रीमेंट ऑफ 1%. द टोटल कैमल पॉपुलेशन हैज शोन एन डिक्रीमेंट ऑफ 37.1%. सो रिमेंबर दिस फिगर, दिस देयर हैज बीन अ ड्रास्टिक चेंज, अ ड्रास्टिक डिक्रीमेंट इन द टोटल कैमल पॉपुलेशन एंड दिस हैज डिक्लाइन बाई 37%. तो हमने जो मेजर जितनी भी स्पीशीज देखी है उसमें आपको क्या है, कैमल हैज बीन Camel population has been declining. So indigenous cattle, pigs and camel, they have shown a decrement. Otherwise, all other species have shown an increment by some figure, all right? So this were all about today's session. I hope you like it. In case you have any queries, do post it down, all right? And we'll see you in the next session. Till then, keep working hard, keep studying.